guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is, today's video is all about this little girl here. She's so beautiful. There'll be a lot of like inserted clips of videos and photos of her, but it's all about her and her 1 year journey of the time we adopted her. Well, I adopted. You're my pretty kitty. Come here. Come here. Sorry about that. That falls way too often. It's a very frequent occurrence. Safe. Hello. You're so beautiful. Yeah, this video is about the time. Let me just level this a bit so you can actually see what's going on. Okay. No, she's still out of frame. It's okay. This little girl here, her name is Niah. She's a beautiful, short-haired, I don't know, because she was adopted. But she is just absolutely stunning, as you can see. And she's my cat, obviously, if you haven't gathered that. I don't generally upload on a Saturday. You would know that if you're loyal to my channel. Today is a very special day that this video is being uploaded, because today marks 1 year of having Niah in my life. I'm not going to get emotional in this video. So today, June 8th, 2019 marks 1 year of having this beautiful little girl in my life. I adopted her 1 year ago today, June 8th, 2018. And I'm here to say, obviously adopt, don't shop, yes, but also, if you do choose to adopt, 9 times out of 10, it's not all sunshines and rainbows, and it is hard at the start. It is hard. Don't give up, don't lose hope. I was told when we got her that she was never going to, how do you put it, like, she was never going to warm up to us and she was never going to come around. Oh, she's playing with this at the moment. That's probably why there's, you can see there's resistance. That's because she's got a grip on it. Come on. You got a good grip on it. We were told that she was never going to come around, and that, you know, she was just going to hide all the time and not want anything to do with us. Okay, well, that clearly wasn't true, because you've seen that she's been all over me. It's not easy adopting, because, yeah, for the first few, I think it was maybe 3 weeks. Yeah, she wanted nothing to do with us. I did start losing hope, because I really thought, oh, maybe they were right. Like, maybe she's never going to come around. But no, she did. She's beautiful. She did. She came around. It took about 3 weeks until she would come out of her hiding spot. Even then, it wasn't much. It was more just to, like, get food. She definitely didn't like being touched for a long time. She was terrified of all of us. And I have a loud family, so that doesn't help. That's just the reality of it, so she would have to get used to it one way or another. Come here. So, like, as you can see here, like, they said that this was never going to happen, and it's clearly happening right now, so proof proven wrong. For the better. So, yeah, she's just so beautiful. Okay. She's still got a long journey to go. She still hates being picked up. She can't stand being picked up. Oh, that is not the rope. That's my leg that you're digging into. She's still got a long way to go because she... that's my leg. You have sharp claws. You have really sharp claws. Please, Niah. Come here. Oh, thank you. Okay. Good girl. Good girl. She hates being picked up like this. Oh, she's tolerating it a little bit. But yeah, like picked up in general, she can't do that. If you try and pick her up and bring her close to you, I would give you an example, but it really hurts because she scratches the crap out of you. So I like don't really want to do that right now. You can have it. Look, there you go. But yeah, she hates being picked up, don't you? Don't you? Yes, you do. Oh, so close. She gives me kisses every now and then, but it's very, very rare. Yeah, she's definitely not a huge fan of that. She's beautiful. Oh, I love her so much. Oh, this is a hard one to film. But basically, yeah, don't give up. Don't lose hope. We definitely did for a bit. I'm not going to lie to you. But Mum did say that she would be able to make her come around because she's done that with cats in her past, so she'll be able to work her magic on Niah, and she did. She definitely did. Thank you, Mum. So yeah, she's come a long way in a year. She has a long way to go as well, so that's exciting. But wait, don't fall off, don't fall off. That's the edge of the bed. She sleeps with me every night. There's definitely her fur in my mouth right now. See that blanket? This aqua blanket right here is hers. Can see how it's hers? She associates that with like sleep. So when I like pull that into like a kind of ball sort of thing and I put it next to me while I'm sleeping, she'll jump into that and just sleep. You're a good girl, aren't you? You're a good girl. She just fell off the bed. She's so angry at me, right? It's not my fault. It's not my fault. It's not my fault that you did that. I warned you that was the edge of the bed. Oh, my makeup. Come here, come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. She'll come back eventually, but she's angry at me right now. You see that? Yeah, she's got a hold of it. Anyways, so I basically just wanted to tell you like her progress. Like, first 3 weeks, she wasn't good with us like at all. Which sucked a bit. And I was really devastated because I fell in love with her, and then to see her change from this cat in a cage, I guess it was because she, you know, she lived in a cage, and she was very confident knowing that the cage was there, so she would come up to us when we were like outside of the cage, if that makes sense, like when we would go visit her and see, you know, she was the cat for us, she would come like right up and like, you know, be fine. I guess just the comfort of knowing that that barrier was there and that no one could get to her was what made her so confident, but as soon as she was taken out of it, whole different story. So yeah, that really sucked, but it's okay. I think it was like going on like 4 or 5 days and she didn't eat anything, so that was a big scare. Then obviously she did start to eat. That is normal for cats, by the way, to when they're moving into a new home. Just not eat for a few days. Don't freak out too much. If it does exceed like 5 days, probably do something about it. But yeah, I think she went like 3 or 4 days and we were like, oh my god, that she's gonna die. But no, like they're smarter than that. They know that if they starve themselves, they'll die. So they just, yeah, I don't know how to describe to you. She ate eventually, obviously. But yeah, just having a place for her to call her own and to get used to is like pretty crucial. So she had my room. My room was her room for so many months of her life. Come on, are you angry at me still? You're winking at me. You're not angry at me. Come on. Good girl.
So for quite a long period of her life, my room was her room. Ugh. Yeah, for a while she wouldn't come out, but she had like her own little corner. There was a chair in the corner, and she would use that chair to hide under. And she used to use my bed to hide under, so we had to take the wheels off that and make it flat on the ground so she couldn't get under it. So she wasn't happy about that, but I didn't like the fact of her being under my bed and not knowing, like, if something would happen, she would just, you know, it just makes me uncomfortable. Like, if something would happen or something would give in on my bed, she would be crushed, and I just, so I made sure she wasn't able to do that anymore. She was very playful, probably like a month into having her, maybe a month and a half. She loves lasers. Yeah, that was a big one. She loves lasers. I don't think I really have any videos or photos of like the fact that that corner of my room used to be like completely hers. Like, it was decked out with a cat tree. Her food, her water, her litter, everything was in her room. So there was that. She used to do like every single, like routinely, every single morning at like 3 a.m. Great time, Naya. She would do the largest, nastiest in a litter box. And I can't describe how revolting her in particular. Like, I've had other cats in my life. No one smells like hers. No one. It is god awful. Like, I cannot describe to you. It is the most gut-wrenching, breathtaking, like, oh my god, I cannot breathe, overwhelming smell. So yeah, I had to live with that for several months of her doing that routinely every freaking morning at 3 a.m. No other time, just 3 a.m. all the time. So that was fun, but anything for you, Naya. Yeah, that's what I thought. Be grateful. But yeah, that was fun. So yeah, there was a lot of like things that I guess people would say as like negatives, but like I could not describe to you how much I love this cat, so it's not a negative for me. To have to clean up her or have that happen at 3 a.m. like, I got used to it. So it's fine, everything's fine. But yeah, she's just a very beautiful cat. She's come a long way. So generally, with me and mum, it took some time, but like 2 months maybe, for her to be able to do that and just come up to us and, you know, bang into us and smooch us and like all that sort of stuff. Where is she? Can we get an example? No. She's like, no, I'm comfortable now. Okay, well, you've seen many examples already and there'll be more to come, I'm sure. Like, it took like maybe 2 months for her to come up to me and mum and just be happy with, like, you know, cuddling and stuff like that and patting and being touched. The boys, it was a whole different story. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 boys in the house, 2 girls. I think the second person she came around to was Josh, because he's just like a big cuddly teddy bear, so he's very gentle and nice and not loud. But yeah, that took a long time as well. Who's the last person? I don't even think she's completely come around to Zach yet, because he's just so loud. She'll walk past him, but she's like not okay with him. I don't think he's really ever pet her that much before. That's definitely something we still need to work on. Jessie, she eventually came around to, that was probably like a few months ago that she came around to him as well, so that was like really good as well. And then a few weeks ago would have been Dad. Dad's a scary one. Dad's a big scary one, to her. So yeah, there's some hesitation there. But she's come around to Dad like fairly well. Like, he stomps through the house and that still scares her. She like doesn't like loud sounds and unfamiliar sounds. She's not okay with those. But she has come a long way. That took her some time. Dad really likes her because she's a little bit of a devil when it comes to food. There's been many a times when Mum's left something on her bedside table and I just yoinked it and ran away. And you can't leave any sort of scraps or food scraps around her because she'll grab it, and as soon as she has a grip on it, she'll run, so you can't get it back. Very instinctive like that. Definitely gotta be careful with what I leave on these bedside tables, because she eats it, Mum just like, oh, I'll eat it in a minute. Can't do that, Mum, you can't do that. So he thinks it's funny, and he loves her for it, so that's really good. I really was worried about Dad. I didn't want him to hate her. I didn't want him to not like her or anything like that. I know there was a time where he said, I think, where he said that he thought it was best to give her back up, and that broke my heart, because I was like, why? Like, she's doing so well, there's nothing wrong with her. It's just like, what are you talking about? And he was talking about because that she lived in my room. But like, I didn't care. So I knew she was gonna eventually gravitate outwards, but yeah, it doesn't matter now. He loves her, and we're not getting rid of her because that would break my heart. Because that would just be part two to getting rid of Phoenix and Coco. That's a whole other story that I will talk about one day. Not planning to cry right now, so I'm not going to talk too much about that right now, but yeah, let's not have a repeat of that, please. I'm basically, yeah, here just to tell a story about how I adopted her 1 year ago today, and she's come such a long way. She's got so long to go, but such a long way in 1 year, especially considering we were told that she was never going to come around, for someone who was never going to come around. I think that was a big old lie. She's doing just fine. So, you wanna come here? Mama?
Yeah, I thought so.
Yeah, she's a big old lie, huh?
You're going such a normal day, and I love you so much. You're so beautiful.
I kind of want to show you a kind of a glimpse of her. She hates that. She cannot stand being picked up.
Oh, but you still, oh, okay.
She's getting better with it, definitely, because I have picked her up so many times to like show her where her food is and stuff, so I'm trying to introduce her to the idea of it. But yeah, she hates when people like touch her belly. She's not comfortable with that. So yeah, it's gonna take some time. It's gonna take some time, huh? She's just so beautiful. And I'm willing to put in all the time in the world for you, huh? Yes, I am, because I love you so much. And I'm so proud of you. She's doing well just to put up with this right now. Oh, she's getting a bit antsy. Come on. Good girl. Good girl. It's okay. It's okay. I'm not going to hurt you. You know this. You know this. I'm not going to hurt you. But yeah, I love her so much. It's that much more rewarding, like, because if you were to just shop, I guess, they tend to just be, like, calm cats, and, you know, they don't have much of a history, so they kind of are willing to go with anything that you kind of do or say, so they're really easy to just, like, come around really quick. But it's, like, A, they're so expensive, B, the whole breeding process of them is, like, so wrong and not okay. It's like really disgusting. See, there's so many like stray rescued cats out there that need a home. So I think shopping is just not an option. Like, don't do it. Because they're bred for all the wrong reasons. And then little girls like you just so happen to exist in the world and are wandering around the streets. You get picked up one day and rescued, and then she's just put in a cage waiting for someone to adopt her. Doesn't have much of a life, doesn't have a family, doesn't have a home. I think it's just such a better moral and story just to adopt. Come on, Mama. Dee, it's so much more rewarding because you know you have to put in time and effort to make them come around, and it's so rewarding. Like, I was telling my boyfriend the other day how much, like, I'll just look over at Niah and I just want to cry because I'll see her doing something and I'll think back to the time where that in my head was never an option. Like, oh, she's never going to be like that because, you know, the place told us that she's never going to come around. So just to see her doing the things that we were told she was never going to do, it just makes you want to cry sometimes, of happy tears, obviously. But, yeah, it's just so many times, like, literally so many times a day, I'll look at Niah and I'll just want to cry because I'll be like, I'm so proud of you. I am so, so so incredibly proud of how far you've come. Like, so proud. You know what I mean? It's just so much more rewarding. And, yeah, I could not love another being as much as I love her. And I would hope she feels the same way about me because I'm her mama. So, yeah, it's just so much more rewarding. And I just could not love you any more than I already do. You're just so beautiful. Yes, you are. So beautiful. Wanted to upload this video more for me than anything else, just to like be able to look back on it and remember her progress that she made in a year. Huh? And get to see the progress that she's made in two. So I can look back at her next year on this day and be like, wow, she's come even further since then. You know what I mean? It's just like a rewarding thing to make this video and be able to look back on it. And just also to remind you guys, adopt, don't shop. Because little girls like her need a home. Don't you? Because little girls like her need a home. And a family. And I like to think I got awfully lucky because, hey, she's just beautiful inside. But like, look at her pattern and her fur and like her green eyes. Oh, she's just so beautiful. So I got very lucky with her. I was so surprised that she had not already been adopted. But yeah, she was worth all $160. If you were curious about that, she came vaccinated, deworm, microchipped, all that sort of stuff. All that was done for her. She was only $160, whereas you're looking at a lot more for a bred kitten. And generally half the time you have to pay for the dissexing and the microchipping and the deworming and the defleeing and all that sort of stuff. So that's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars, all for something that is not a good cause. Whereas $160 for something that is a great cause. So I got her through the Central Coast Animal Facility. So like cost per pound. And yeah, I wouldn't change her. I wouldn't change anything at all. I had a great experience with them. They were great people. They were so lovely. If you live in the area, do go check it out, because there are a lot of animals in there that do need homes. Such like beautiful dogs. There's some really lovely, beautiful dogs there. And there's like little puppies there. There's kittens. There's cats. Like, there's so many animals that need adopting and need a home there. So please do go check it out if you want an animal. Check that place out. Don't look online and try and buy an animal. I would definitely suggest adopting. It's just, like I said, so much more rewarding, and you feel so much better knowing that you took this beautiful animal. I just want to squeeze beautiful animal and gave it a home, because she didn't have one prior. That's basically what this video is. It's a little bonus video on the Saturday. And just because it's easier, I don't know exactly when she was born. The pound doesn't even know all that information. They can only guess. But just for the sake of everything being so much easier, I call this day her birthday. It's not, because she wasn't born on this day. But it's harder to say her adoption day, that just sounds weird. So the 8th of June is her birthday in my eyes. So yeah, this is actually filmed on the Thursday. It's going to be uploaded on the Saturday, but it's filmed on Thursday. So I can't wait to see her on the Saturday and wish her a happy birthday. And yeah, just see how far she's come and be so proud of her and smother her with love, because I love her. So yeah, that's that. Yeah, I just wanted to make this video to kind of show you how far she's come, for being a scared little cat in the corner that would not leave that corner, to being able to walk up and snooch just about anyone in the house. Zach, on a good day, if he's been quiet, she will, but if he's been loud like he is now, but that's okay, because she's getting used to it. She is definitely getting used to it. Oh, also, I should probably mention the fact that we do have a puppy, so she has been housed with our other dog, with our dog, sorry. And I've got videos of Satchmo here. Satchmo and her don't get along, but it's nothing like... Zach, shush! It's nothing like worrying or anything like that, because they're like... She kind of like walks all over Puppy and is just kind of very snarky towards Puppy and knows that she's not going to get hurt because she's smarter than Puppy. because Puppy is very dumb. She's a dumb little dog, that one, but she's so cute. Yeah, they don't get along in the way that, like, they can't just sit next to each other and be fine. But they're generally housed on two separate ends of the house. Puppy's generally with Josh all the time and just always in Josh's room. So it's not really much of an issue because she's generally in here or up this way in the house. Or she'll be outside on her little cat tree. Most likely she has like seven cat trees out there, but like on one of the cat trees or on the ladder that she sleeps on sometimes. So yeah, there's generally not an issue because she's always up high and Puppy's obviously down low. And they come and stuff, like they can walk past each other and it's fine, but like they're not happy about it, you know what I mean? Like you can tell. And Puppy does try and run at her sometimes, but Puppy gets yelled at and she learns. And Naya knows she's not in danger because Puppy would never actually bite her or anything like that. She just doesn't like the fact that there's something else that gets attention, because Puppy's an attention seeker too. So yeah. Oh, she's gonna get out of me. Oofed. Come here. Yeah, that's basically it for today's video. Hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, that's all we have, huh? Alrighty guys, that's it for today's video. Be sure to give it a like and share this video. If you're new to the channel, you should join the family by making the red subscribe button down below turn grey, with the extra addition of the letter D at the end as well. I make new videos every Sunday and sometimes Wednesday and sometimes Saturday. So be sure to turn on post notifications to be alerted of those up and coming videos, as well as following my social medias to be alerted on there also. Thank you guys so much for watching. We love you. And don't forget, everything's gonna be okay in the end, and if it's not okay, it's not the end. Cue the outro.